Simone, Simone, tell us your title, what you do.
All right, well, my name is Simone Perez, and I am the Tapena Grab a Fork 2010 Summer Tour Ambassador.
It's a mouthful, yeah.
It is, most definitely, but it is.
No pun intended with the Grab a Fork, that's a mouthful.
So basically, we're doing a national campaign where we are starting to do happy hours in various cities in the U.S. So tonight we're in Tampa at Ceviche and Tapas, and tomorrow we will be in Miami, followed by Chicago and then Dallas. So, you know, great U.S. cities, and we're just trying to amp up the Tapena brand and bring people, you know, good wine, good food.
I've seen Tapena around in some retail shops around here. Tell us a little bit about the wines. We could actually get into it. I'll come back to you a little bit later. But you know, while we're drinking, you know, we'll have some, you know, we'll get some glasses out. But just, you know, what style of wines are they? Food friendly, that kind of thing.
Well, we are very food friendly wines, and we are actually a Spanish wine, and we have four varietals. So right here is our little collection. And we have a Tempranillo, a Rosé, Verdejo, and a Garnacha. Now, people might know Garnacha with their other name, Grenache.
As Grenache,
so,
yes.
Yep, it's the same varietal, just different names, different locations that they're from. So we're Spanish wine, as I said, so we're Garnacha. And they're, as I was saying, very food-friendly. They're a great summer barbecue wine, so the rosé is, you know, perfect thing to bring to friends gathering to have at your own. They go great just with anything you can put on the grill. It's pretty much great pairing with Tapena.
So, and where do these bottles come in price-wise, you know, roughly in retail? What kind of price point can you find them at?
So for most chain grocery stores in Florida, they are around $12 to $15 a bottle. So it's really inexpensive for myself. You know, I'm 22 years old, just got out of college.
You don't look a day over 21,
okay,
by the way.
There you go. I am legal. So, you know, it's important to be able to spend your own money on a great bottle of wine. And it's the first time where, you know, this is my first job out of college. And, you know, it's wonderful to be able to learn about this Spanish wine, to be able to afford it nonetheless, you know, at a grocery store, to be able to buy a bottle and enjoy it with friends, family, whomever.
Yeah, I mean, it's always good to be able to connect with a name brand. Like, you know, you can, if you like one Tapena, you try the rest of the line, and, you know, they're pretty much line priced, roughly, kind of like all priced about the same for any of the brands.
Yep, they're all around $12 to $15, and yeah.
That's great. I'm a big fan of Garnacha, especially like old vine Garnacha. Like Garnacha, or is this an old vine's Grenache or Garnacha? Or no? No? I don't know. We're going to find out.
We will find that.
We're going to find out when we come back and we can taste the wine. I'm assuming that's going to be a nice, you know, medium to full body wine with good texture. I'm all over that wine, so I can't wait to try
it. It's full, as you're saying, full mouthful, so it's pretty good.
All right, I'm all over it. All right, Simone, thank you very much. We'll be back in a few minutes. We'll try some wines, and we'll be back with you. Thank you so much.
Grab a fork.
We're in South Tampa on South Howard. We are sitting with a group of folks. We are talking about Tapena wines. And everyone has tried the entire line of wines, all 16 of them. So I think you're all taking a cab home.
Taking a cab home.
Taking a cab home.
New wines. Awesome.
I'm kidding. There's only four wines. There was there's a Verdejo, there's a Rosé, a Tempranillo, and a Garnacha. Otherwise known as Cadillac. Dry rosé. All right, so one at a time, don't step on any toes. What did everyone think of the wines and the pairings? and be specific. If you like something, just go ahead and shout it out.
The pears were good. Overall, my favorite wine is probably the Tempranillo. However, as far as the best pairing, went the Verdeo and the squid ceviche, calamari ceviche. That pairing just really stood out. And the wine accented the ceviche and vice versa.
What do you think of the value of Tapena? Do you think for like a $12 to $15 retail price point, it's one that you would seek out in some retail spots?
At the price point, yeah, it's a definite value.
Decent value, okay. How about the ladies? Let's get the female perspective on things. Let's get the female take. What do you think?
I definitely like the Tempranillo.
Okay.
I definitely like that, but I really enjoyed the pairing of the grenache with the peppers.
Okay,
that
good.
Was very good. But I like the Tempranillo wine as far as the flavors, the full body.
Partake in the raffle. Did you happen to win anything?
No.
I did.
I know.
It was awesome.
What is that?
So shut up.
Yeah, I won.
It wasn't fixed.
I won.
Yeah,
it was one of the first times ever. How about you, my dear? Lady in the middle. The spread between the bread. What'd you think?
I actually really enjoyed dry rosé. I thought the Tapena dry rosé was absolutely fantastic. I thought it had, really nice body, but still really, really good flavor. It was, off dry, not too sweet. And I don't eat mussels, but for several of the other dishes, I thought it was a really great pairing.
What about, how's the acidity? Like, good for food pairing or like, with wafer, better off as wafer?
I think right down the middle, and I think really great with the food, the type of food that we here in Florida enjoy so much. And the wine's available in Publix. Stick it right in your grocery cart and take it home. I think grab a fork is an excellent solution.
There you go. I think not enough people, I think we were talking about this earlier when I stopped by, but I was talking to you guys. Not enough people are drinking rosé in Florida, and it's crazy.
I agree. Not enough people drink rosé.
This is the area for rosé. I think the French would slap us if they could. They'd reach right across the ocean and slap us.
I'm Italian, so that doesn't mean anything to me.
Yeah.
I enjoy my red, so that's why.
But a nice light rosé in summer when it's too hot. You don't want a wine that drinks like a meal. You don't want the chunky soup of wine. When it's hot out, have a nice dry rosé, and it's a beautiful thing. You get that red fruit expression, the light body of a white, the acidity of a white. It goes fantastic with food. And being Italian, wine is food.
It is wine,
right?
Definitely.
Grazie mille. Simone.
Hello.
Simone, how was the event tonight? We're right at the wrap-up of the event. I mean, there's still plenty of people here, but as most wine events go, they always last a little bit longer than planned. So,
exactly.
How'd it go tonight?
It's our first event.